it yet?
Yeah, we'll go into that some other time.
The average man would go after the reward. All you seem to be...
Listen, did anybody ever make a sucker out of you? This is a matter of principle. Something you probably wouldn't understand. But when anybody takes me for a buggy ride, I don't like the idea of having to pay for the privilege.
Were you taken for a buggy ride?
Yes, with all the trimmings.
So, we're supposed to be choosing a Best Supporting Actress, 1935, as part of the DeOscarize.com What If World that we started last time with Best Supporting Actor. Please see Clark Gable Got Robbed by the Academy. Now, as that title implies, an injustice was done to Clark Gable that was sort of rectified the following subsequent years, when the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences established award categories for supporting players. In point of fact, it was not rectified for Gable, really, because Gable never won another award after winning in 1934, for It Happened One Night, a runaway hit that year that garnered the first ever Big Five Awards for Best Picture.
Do you mind if I ask you a question, frankly? Do you love my daughter?
Best Director.
Any guy that had fallen in love with your daughter ought to have his head examined.
Now that's an evasion.
Best Actor.
What she needs is a guy that'd take a suck at her once a day, whether it's coming to her or not. If you had half the brain you're supposed to have, you'd have done it yourself long ago.
Best Actress.
Do you love her?
A normal human being couldn't live under the same roof with her without going nutty.
And Best Screenplay.
I asked you a simple question. Do you love her?
Yes! But don't hold that against me. I'm a little screwy myself.
The first time in movie history, and not repeated until 41 years later, with One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest in 1975.
Excuse me, miss. Do you think it might be possible to turn that music down so maybe a couple of the boys could talk?
Your hand is staining my window.
God almighty, she's got you guys coming and going. Ah, come on, you're not gonna say that now. You're not gonna say that now.
I don't think he's overly psychotic.
I want that television set turned on right now!
I think he's dangerous.
Jesus, I mean, you guys do nothing but complain about how you can't stand it in this place here, and then you haven't got the guts just to walk out. I mean, what do you think you are, for Christ's sake, crazy or something? Well, you're not.
Back to 1934 now, with that unprecedented Big Five win for It Happened One Night. Something else happened in 1934 that was also unprecedented. For the first and only time, the Academy experienced a bit of a backlash when Bette Davis was snubbed by the Academy for Best Actress 1934, despite her wonderful performance in Of Human Bondage. The Hollywood community rebelled. One of the nominees, Norma Shearer, at that time the first lady of MGM and the wife of movie mogul Irving Thalberg, conducted a campaign to rectify the injustice done to Bette Davis for what was a remarkable performance of a role no other actress in Hollywood had the courage to accept.
And after you kissed me, I always used to wipe my mouth. Wipe my mouth! For every kiss I had, a laugh. We laughed at you because you were such a mug, a mug, a mug.
Now, at that time, nominations were made by committee, and Norma Shearer's hard work cowered the Academy into allowing, for the first and only time, the acting members to write in an actress of their choice in addition to the nominees already selected by the committee. Bette Davis was the first ever write-in candidate for an Academy Award and came in second to Claudette Colbert.
Here comes a car.
Okay, now watch me. I'm going to use number one. Keep your eye on that thumb, baby, and see what happens.
I got my eye on the thumb.
Something must have gone wrong. Oh. Try number two.
When you get to 100, wake me up.
Because of the impact of her performance in Of Human Bondage, Bette Davis thought she'd finally earned a chance to play the better movie parts, and was thrilled to have been requested by Columbia Pictures to play the lead opposite Clark Gable in a movie called, wait for it, or perhaps you've already guessed, It Happened One Night. Unfortunately, Harry Warner, Bette Davis's boss at Warner Brothers Studios, got mad at Columbia Pictures boss Harry Cohn for some reason or another. I think it was over a bridge game or something. And he refused him his actress's service. So Claudette Colbert got the part and got the prize. Claudette Colbert was nominated again the very next year. As for Bette Davis, It appears the Academy was bound and determined to make sure she would win a Best Actress award. She tied with the fifth place nominee, and so the Academy changed the rules and went with six nominees rather than the five previously agreed upon. It was kind of like a Fox News presidential debate, where the rules keep changing until they get the group they want. Anyway, Bette Davis was nominated, and of course, she won Best Actress 1935 for her performance in a rather predictable melodrama called Dangerous, with a scene eerily similar to the scene in Of Human Bondage that got her all that attention the year before.
Hurt me? Oh, I should laugh at you, should I, but I can't help it. I thought you might at least be amusing, but you turned out to be dull and stupid and so afraid. Hurt me? Get out of here before you give me hysterics!
Sound familiar? Good, because there's more, lots more. Investigating the circumstances of 1935 have led to all kinds of revelations and reminders that will be discussed further on the next edition of DeOscarize.com. We're going to hear all about the Bette Davis-Joan Crawford feud, the Bette Davis-Miriam Hopkins feud, and we're going to de-Oscarize Bette Davis for an award that she always considered a consolation prize anyway, and name a new Best Actress 1935. This nominee, in our alternate reality of deoscarize.com, was not even nominated in the real world way back then, but she sure should have been. So, please be on the lookout for the next edition of DeOscarize.com Part 2. That's another first in an alternate reality that's getting to feel a little too real. Not quite Twilight Zone time at DeOscarize.com, but we may be getting there.
Mr. Chambers! Mr. Chambers! Don't get on that ship! Rest of the book, To Serve Man... It's a cookbook!